Serving in the SFAB is a duty and an honor, and you're representing our nation and our Army. We put the best person forward in front of our partner forces to build those lasting relationships, because we want someone of good moral character, someone of good confidence with those communication skills to be able to stand in front of our allied partners. My name is Lionel Balloon. My rank is Sergeant Major. I am a part of the SFAC Division staff. We run assessment and selection for the entire organization, which includes the SFABs. I oversee the assessment and selection process from its inception in processing and out processing. Originally, it was a 2-day course. Then it morphed into a 5-day course with more centric focus tied to the advisor attributes. The advisor attributes are holistic points that a candidate must show in order to be a guideline or baseline to see if that person is a good fit for the organization. We have four pillars that culminate, that gives a holistic view of the soldier. And those four pillars are the cadre assessment, the peer assessment, the psychological assessment, and the senior leader selection board. They all work collectively to give that impartiality and holistic view of the service member coming through assessment and selection. Each pillar has its own unique capabilities. So for example, the cadre assessment is that day-to-day ground and collecting the analytical data of how the candidate performs during assessment and selection.
I try to identify character. Competence is one of those things that can be taught, whereas character is kind of inherited, and it's harder to reshape, redevelop character. What makes most sense to me, especially in line with what SFABs are currently doing, having a high tolerance for ambiguity, using decisive initiative and going and executing the mission, right, with minimal guidance or oversight. Once I see that kind of shine through, I can kind of get a good feel for where the candidate stands, at least on their own. We put them through the rigors of the course and kind of see where their character lies within that team dynamic, and I think that plays a big factor in whether I think they'd be a good fit in a small team dynamic.
Obviously, peer feedback, you know, the naming convention. How does that candidate, or how is that candidate perceived by his or her peers while actually going through the course? The psychological assessment deals with, you know, psychological indicators, whether they be good or bad.
So the psychological evaluation portion of assessment selection really helps to drive home some of the stuff that we as cadre are not formally trained on. So we really focus on our pieces as assessment cadre towards the more physical events, right? The period of assessment that is observed behavior versus the psychologists do what would be considered unobserved behavior. Being able to retain information, being able to retain knowledge is kind of hit in the IQ test. They get to see a little bit of like what their personal life like, what's their financial life like, and then using historical facts and data, seeing how that could play out in the future should they become a hire. Identifying risk is really what we're trying to get at.
The cadre here are just trying to, you know, make sure you really want to be here. It's fun. It's honestly fun. It's being an E7. It's, you know, I haven't done anything like this in a very long time, and it's good to get back to it sometimes. You're going to be out with just you and your team in some places, and they need to count on you that you're going to get the job done and the mission done. And so I think this selection does a really good process to do that.
Have an advisor attribute that you were explicitly tested on, and can you give me an example?
For me, I'd say it would be empathy. When you get around leaders that have completely different backgrounds, you kind of have to step back and say, hey, I'm a little different, but it's not a bad thing, and they're a little different, it's not a bad thing either. So let's get together and let's try to make this work together as a team.
I think every individual piece of the selection kind of plays to different people's strengths. Now, there's definitely a social component to it, and that can be easy or hard for different people. There's physical components, there's intellectual components. You look to the whiteboard for what's next, but other than some rumors floating around, you only really know what's next as they give you the information. So it's very ambiguous. You don't really know what's coming up. You don't know all the things you're going to be tested on. None of the standards are published for time, stuff like that. So you kind of got to come in and just do your best.
Come here and know that, like, nobody else knows what's going on. So just do whatever comes with the day-to-day task and take it with a grain of salt and just move forward with it. That's definitely been tested every hour, every situation, every day.
The fear of the unknown, I get it. There's a fear of failure, a fear of I don't know what's coming next, but put your best foot forward and you will have success. It is doable, it is achievable, it is not hard. No matter what's your job, what's your rank, what's your MOS, I promise you this assessment selection is very, very achievable.